This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Professional Bowlers Association PBA is the major sanctioning body for the sport of professional 10-pin bowling in the United States, headquartered in Seattle, Washington. The PBA membership consists of almost 4,300 members worldwide. Members include pro shop owners and workers, teaching professionals and bowlers who compete in the various events put on by the association. The PBA also oversees competition between professional bowlers via the following tours: PBA Tour 21 20th Century 22 21st Century 3 References and Footnotes 4 External Links Hall of Fame. The PBA Hall of Fame was founded in 1975 with 8 initial inductees, 6 for performance: Ray Bluth, Don Carter, Carmen Salvino, Harry Smith, Dick Weber and Billy Wheelu, and 2 for meritorious service: Frank Esposito and Chuck Pisano. Since its inception, it was located at the International Bowling Museum and Hall of Fame in St. Louis, Missouri. It is now part of the new USBC headquarters in Arlington, Texas. Through 2012, there are 89 PBA Hall of Fame members in 3 categories: performance 45, meritorious service 27, veterans, senior 17. Membership in the Hall of Fame was originally determined by annual elections from 2000 to 2008. Those in the performance category had to have 10 PBA titles or 2 major championships on their resume, as well as be retired from the tour for 5 years. Another revision took effect in 2008. Bowlers can now qualify for the Hall of Fame based on 5 PBA titles on their resume, as long as 2 of those titles were major championships. Other active bowlers can now qualify for the Hall as well if they have 20 years of membership and are elected. Late in 2008, the PBA announced the launch of a new PBA Seniors Hall of Fame. John Hangard, the all-time leader in PBA Senior titles 14, became the first inductee on January 24, 2009. In January 2016, Ryan Gasparovic was nominated in the PBA Hall of Fame. His notable act of scoring a perfect series score of 902 times in a year during Michigan's regional competition held at Score Lanes in Taylor, Michigan. PBA history. 20th century. Prior to the PBA's inception, bowling was broadcast on television sporadically beginning in the early 1950s. NBC began with an early 1950s special telecast entitled Championship Bowling. Later regular weekly bowling shows, including Make That Spare and Jackpot Bowling, began airing nationally at the same time. There was a desire to start a professional bowling division in the United States, an effort led by Eddie Elias, a sports agent based in Akron, Ohio. During the 1958 ABC American Bowling Congress tournament in Syracuse, New York, 60 men, including Don Carter, Frank Esposito, Buzz Fazio, Matt Lebhar, Carmen Salvino, Billy Wheelu, Glenn Allison, Steve Nagy, Harry Smith, Ray Bluth, Dick Hoover, Bill Bonetta, Robert Bobby Bellew, and Junie McMahon, attended a presentation by Elias after listening to his proposal. 33 of the men donated $50 each, totaling $1,650 to start the organization, which was incorporated in 1958, and headquartered in Akron. The investors then became charter members of the PBA, basically giving them lifetime membership. Bill Bonetta was slated to be the first commissioner of the PBA by Eddie Elias, but Bill was still a very active bowler and turned down the position to continue his bowling and teaching career. Competition began in 1959 with 3 tournaments. Italian-born Lou Campi of Dumont, New Jersey won the first event, the Empire State Open, and Dick Weber won the other 2, Paramus Eastern Open and the Dayton Open. The PBA Tour slowly built an audience, expanding to 7 tournaments in 1960, then 13 tournaments in 1961, before exploding with 30 tour stops in 1962. Weber would become the first face of the PBA in the early years, as he won 10 of the first 23 events held, including 7 in 1961 alone. While PBA bowlers regularly appeared on Jackpot Bowling and Make That Spare, Elias led an effort to give the PBA a permanent home on television, which it would find on ABC Sports by 1965. See also, Professional Bowlers Tour, coupled with the continued support of its charter. members, as well as sponsorships by the Ford Motor Company, Coca-Cola, which sponsored 11 tournaments in 1963 alone, True Value Hardware and Firestone Tire. The PBA experienced growth in its tournament schedules and prize funds. Annual incomes for professional bowlers became, at the time, very competitive with other professional sports. A Sports Illustrated article from 1963 noted that top bowler Harry Smith stood to make as much money in 1963 as Major League Baseball's NL MVP Sandy Koufax and NFL football MVP Y.A. Tittle. Combined schedules reached a plateau of 35 tournaments per year in the 1980s. The 1965 Tournament of Champions was the first to offer $100,000 in prize money. The 1982 event featured a $200,000 purse, and the 1987 U.S. Open, sponsored by Seagram Distillery, offered a $500,000 prize fund, as well as the first $100,000 first place prize in PBA history. By the 1980s, True Value pledged $100,000 to any roller of a perfect game on national television, increased to a $200,000 sum during its own True Value Open. Prior to this, the PBA would award a televised 300 game with $10,000 and a new Ford automobile in addition. In the early 1990s, the Miller Brewing Company offered $1 million to any bowler who could win all three of its sponsored tournaments in a given season. As television exposure increased for the PBA, it spun off a seniors tour in 1981, with Bill Beach winning the first seniors championship that year. In 1986, a group of professional bowlers who were dissatisfied with PBA management formed the Touring Pro Bowlers TPB Group. After meeting resistance, the TPB took on the PBA in an antitrust suit, though settled out of court. The lawsuit did serious financial damage to the PBA. Elias continued to be involved in the PBA until his death in 1998. The tour logo used the first 40-plus years 21st century. The PBA was purchased in March 2000 by former Microsoft executives Chris Peters, chairman, Rob Glazer, and Mike Slade, and its corporate headquarters were moved to Seattle, Washington, together with CEO Steve Miller, a former Nike executive. They are recognized for rescuing the PBA from the brink of extinction as of 2011. Jeff Reese currently serves as the PBA's CEO, and Tom Clark serves as commissioner. These two assumed the shared CEO-commissioner post that was held by Fred Schreier since he took over for Miller in 2005. The PBA was featured in the 2006 sports documentary, A League of Ordinary Gentlemen. The documentary, filmed during the 2002-2003 season, enjoyed a limited release in theaters before being released in a DVD format in March 2006. The PBA was also featured and acknowledged in 2007 film 7-10 Split. In 2003, the PWBA Professional Women's Bowling Association folded, and the PBA began allowing female members in 2004. Missy Bellinder Parkin became the first female PBA member, while Liz Johnson became the first to cash in a PBA Tour event, and later 2005 the first to make a PBA Tour telecast in conjunction with the USBC. The PBA would later inaugurate the PBA Womens Series in 2007 following ESPN telecasts of the US Women's Open. It brought back semi-regular women's bowling telecasts for the first time since the demise of the PWBA. The top two seeds out of a field of 16 faced each other in one match, aired prior to the men's championship match. The Women's Series expanded from four events in 2007 to eight events in the 2008-09 and 2009-10 seasons, before being cancelled. A PBA Extra Frame tournament broadcast set up in 2009. Financial difficulties and the general state of the U.S. economy caused the tour to reduce the number of tour stops and overall events, while also reducing the number of live TV finals broadcasts. The PBA combined its fall schedule of six standard PBA tournaments plus qualifying for the PBA World Championship into a single World Series of Bowling event, held that year in Allen Park, Michigan near Detroit. All fall TV finals except the PBA World Championship were taped and aired at a later date on ESPN, while all but one of the Winter Tour events continued to hold live TV finals. In 2010, the World Series of Bowling was moved to Las Vegas, Nevada, and consisted of five tournaments with taped TV finals and qualifying for the PBA World Championship. The overall schedule that season was reduced to just 12 title events, with portions of three winter season events being taped and aired after the fact. Kelly Kulik won the 2010 PBA Tournament of Champions, where she was the first ever female competitor in the field. This also made her the first woman to win any Professional Bowlers Association Tour event that was also open to men for the 2011-12 season. A total of 14 TV broadcasts were taped at the 2011 World Series of Bowling in Las Vegas to be aired on later dates for the first time. The TV finals for the PBA World Championship did not air live. In fact, ESPN only aired the finals of the PBA's three remaining major tournaments, USBC Masters, US Open, and Tournament of Champions, in a live 2012 broadcast. All other ESPN broadcasts for winter 2012 were taped events from the World Series, while four additional non-major title tournaments were available live via the PBA's Extra Frame webcast service, along with reduced stops. Prize funds for some standard tournaments were reduced, starting in 2010, with as little as $15,000 going to the winner. The 2011 Tournament of Champions, however, did offer a PBA record $1 million prize fund and an unprecedented $250,000 top prize. References and footnotes. ABCDE about the PBA. PBACOM, the 17th of January 2011, retrieved the 12th of January 2014. Article at www.pbacom on August 13, 2012. Regional Tour information. PBA editor. New rules for Hall of Fame. Professional Bowlers Association. PBACOM retrieved the 12th of January 2014. Senior title. Article at www.pbacom, October 25, 2009. ESPN The Magazine. Rick Riley. How about a little recognition for bowling champ Kelly Kulick? SportsEspingo.com, the 26th of February 2010. Retrieved the 16th of April 2015. 1964, 1965, 1966, 1967, 1968, 1969, 1970, 1971, 1972, 1973, 1974, 1975, 1976, 1977, 1978, 1979, 1980, 1981. 1982, 1983, 1984, 1985, 1986, 1987, 1988, 1989, 1990, 1991, 1992, 1993, 1994, 1995, 1996, 1997, 1998, 1999. 2000, 2001, 02, 2002, 03, 2003, 2004, 2005, 2006, 2007, 2007, 2008, 2008, 2009, 2009, 2010, 2011, 2012, 2013, 2014, 2015, 2016, 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020, 2021, 2022, 2023, 2024, 2025, 2026. Other series. PBA Regional Tour. PBA Womens Series. PBA 50 Tour. VE PBA Tour Events. Major USBC Masters. PBA Tournament of Champions. PBA World Championship. US Open. Others. Round 1. Japan Cup. Motor City Classic. Etonic Championship. Lake County Indiana Classic. CLR Windy City Classic. Great Lakes Classic. Lumber Liquidators Championship. Spartanburg Classic. Construction Jobscom Championship. Lumber Liquidators. Earl Anthony Medford Classic. Motel 6. Dick Weber Open. PBA Exempt Doubles Classic. Bear Classic. Pepsi Championship. Don Johnson Buckeye State Classic. Go RVing Classic. Geico Classic. VE10 Pin Bowling Equipment. Ball Pin Pinsetter Organizations. BTBA ETBF JBC JPBA PBA PTBC PWBA USBC World Bowling WTBA Tournaments WTBA World 10-Pin Bowling Championships WTBA World Singles Championships World Games Asian Games Pan American Games Cubica AMF World Cup European Bowling Tour European Bowling Tour Masters Asian 10-Pin Bowling Championships NCAA Bowling Championship PBA Tour PBA Tournament of Champions PBA World Championship US Open US Women's Open USBC Masters USBC Queens Weber Cup Commonwealth 10-Pin Bowling Championships Mediterranean Challenge Cup World Ranking Masters World 10-Pin Masters Terms 900 Series Dutch 200 Open Frame Perfect Game Spare Split Strike